There once was a wise man. Actually, it was a sailor man named Popeye. This Popeye spent a lot of time talking about the wonders of spinach and the strength it gave him. Little did he know that one day spinach would do more than give you muscles. Innovators are hoping that one day it can give all of us a little heart too. Here's Alie Ward to explain.
Inside a lab at Worcester Polytechnic Institute, you'll find ghostly spinach, which is just ordinary spinach that has been given an extraordinary bath. Through a process called decellularization, the spinach is stripped of its plant cells yet retains its natural leaf structure. These scientists, Professor Glenn Gaudette and Dr. Josh Gerschlack, are researching how to utilize spinach and its natural scaffolding or veins to engineer heart tissue for humans. They aim to do this by stripping spinach of its plant nature, which a human body would reject, and then placing human heart cells onto the spinach scaffolding. If they can successfully oxygenate these tiniest of tissues, this may be the beginning of replacement heart tissue for patients who have suffered a heart attack. I visited Worcester, Massachusetts to meet them and to get the pulse on this new heart science.
How different is the vein structure in our hearts from a spinach leaf?
The leaf structure, it's kind of a collection of tubes that are all collected together. Mm-hmm. Whereas with our blood vessels in our body, it's one long tube that branches off. But we don't think that those differences should be a problem with what we're trying to do.
Our colleagues can take a patient's cells and they can genetically engineer them to turn them into stem cell-like cells.
Once the stem cells are turned into heart muscle cells, Glenn and Josh can place those onto the spinach scaffolds. They started by testing whether red dye could run through the spinach veins, keeping in mind that blood is the goal, because blood carries that essential element, oxygen.
We have a red dye that we have set up on this ring stand, and we're going to perfuse it through the leaf to show the vessels that are in there, just to kind of simulate what could happen if we put it into the body.
Okay, let the perfusion begin. So there's no plant cells in there. Oh, wow.
Yeah, no plant cells yet. The oxygen has to be brought within 100 to 200 microns, which is like the size of a human hair. Mm. And that's why we can't build it. So these structures are what's so important.
Next, they tested bovine blood through the spinach veins. Thicker and more viscous than dye, the blood worked too.
This is important advancement to be able to show that those cells can actually get through that leaf. We really need to start thinking about how can we take the plant kingdom and benefit the animal kingdom other than just as a food source. And so there is so much potential.
Potential that they have begun to tap here in the lab, where heart tissue may one day be recreated with help from Mother Nature.